Yes, guys, this is Adil Maksud. I'm another very much important project I have taken here, AWS Glue ETL project. So ETL is the best thing, extract, transform, and load. But AWS Glue ETL, this is really not so much best. So if you have this one that I have transformed, loaded S3 data into Amazon Redshift, if you have this line or sentence in your resume, your job market will be very much broad for you then. So I suggest please watch this one for senior level or entry level, both. This is important. And it will be like this: S3 bucket here, AWS, then from here data will be extracted, loaded first in the S3 bucket, then extracted glue, then again loaded to the transform, then loaded to the Redshift. So this is the ETL for S3 to Redshift. In between is the glue, and this is the glue ETL job in the console. You can see here. So visual ETL, the first is coming, then Redshift is here. See here, try Redshift serverless free trial. Free trial has 300 credit they are giving. This is interesting because I think more than 1 year ago it was not free like that, no free trial, I think, as I can remember. But now they are is giving the free trial also. And interesting thing is that Redshift is serverless. And this is fully managed petabyte scale cloud data warehouse. If you are sitting for the AWS solution architect or DevOps engineering exam, then also this is very much important. Okay, so let's go through here first. In this project, we will use AWS Glue to extract data from CSV file, actually .csv file, I can say it like this. And store in the, which is stored in the S3 bucket, and transform the data into a more query friendly format, Parquet, and load it into Amazon Redshift for analysis. So Redshift, why we are loading? For analysis, very much important. Analysis words, these kinds of words actually interviewer likes, because a DevOps engineer should have the quality of analysis. Then project steps is like that. Set up the resources, Amazon S3 bucket, store your raw data files, CSV format. First you have to store where S3 bucket, Amazon Redshift cluster, set up a Redshift cluster where the transformed data will be loaded. So first you have to set up a cluster in the Redshift. Then AWS Glue, create the crawlers, jobs, triggers, and that triggers to automate ETL process. So Glue is working with crawlers. So let's see the crawler here in the Glue. Glue has, see, catalog, then ETL job, database. Where is crawler? Here is the crawler. See here, you have to create the crawler, then classify, classifier, then catalog settings. So first of all, you have to create like this color. You can give any color like demo, like the description. Next, data source, you have to give the data source. Yes, if you have the data source. And if you don't have, then also add a data source, you have to write here like this. Which one source? S3 bucket, like this. JDBC, DynamoDB, DocumentDB, Delta Lake, Iceberg, UD. So you have to add the data source there like this. The path should be S3 bucket, S3 path. Here's S3 bucket, then path it should be here. S3 colon // bucket object is coming like this. It's taking the object from the bucket. Okay, prefix, then okay, color also is coming like this. And then you have to create the Redshift cluster. So serverless Redshift cluster. If you go to the Redshift cluster, here see, create the cluster. So you have to create the cluster like this, the name, then all the thing you have to see here. Okay, so before creating the cluster, the free trial is the good. You saw the free trial, right? The dashboard, if you go there, the Redshift dashboard, try the free trial. This is good one. So $300 you will get free there. Okay, that's good. Then extract phase. First is setup, then extract this phase. Create an AWS blue crawler to scan the raw CSV data in the S3 bucket. So blue crawler, I showed you. This crawler will infer the schema and create tables in the AWS Glue data catalog. So crawler will infer which one? Schema. Okay, then transform phase. Extract, then transform. Create a Glue ETL job that reads the data from the Glue data catalog. Convert the CSV file. I like to say .csv files into Parquet format for better performance and a smaller storage size. Applies transformation such as filtering, aggregations, or data type conversions as needed. So then is coming the transformation such as filtering, aggregations, data type, conversion, you have to convert as needed. So here we have to create the ETL job. So let's see the ETL job, which one. So we are not creating right now. So this is the ETL job. See here, ETL job. So yes, you have to create the ETL job. Which one? Visual ETL, notebook, script editor, normally Visual ETL. Visual ETL, see, JSON CSV or Parquet files stored in S3. So Glue data catalog also, which one our system has saved, reads the data from the Glue data catalog. System says for Glue data catalog, that means we have to go here, AWS Glue data catalog. See here, catalog has come here. Okay, then converts the CSV files into Parquet format for better performance and smaller storage size. Applies transformation such as filtering, aggregation, or data type conversion. So here we have not added anything aside. We have to add first, then it will come here. Okay, then load phase, transform. ETL's T is transform, L is load. So in the AWS ETL job, it will load the transform data into an AWS Amazon Redshift table. And Redshift table will be created using the transform schema. Okay, allowing for easier querying. Detailed steps is here. Set up the S3 bucket. Upload CSV files into the S3 bucket such as. Then step 2, create an Amazon Redshift cluster. Set up the Amazon Redshift cluster in your account. Create a database in Redshift where the final transform data will be loaded. Then step 3, create a Glue crawler. In the AWS Glue console, go to the crawlers and create a new crawler. Set up the crawler to scan the S3 bucket. So which bucket? This one. S3, then raw data, right? Yes, see here, S3, my raw data, like this. Then containing your CSV file should be there. Choose an IAM, Identity Access Management role, that has permission to access the S3 bucket. So without role, you cannot do anything else. So you have to create an IAM role that has the permission to access the S3 bucket. Crawler will create a table in the Glue data catalog representing the schema of the raw data. Then step 4, create a Glue ETL job. Go to jobs in the AWS Glue console and create a new jobs. Okay, in the ETL job, use a PySpark script to read the data from the Blue Data Catalog, convert the data from CSV to Parquet, apply transformations like renaming columns or filtering out unnecessary rows, write the transformed Parquet data to another S3 bucket, load the transformed data into the Redshift cluster. Example PySpark ETL script is like that. Is the example import CS from like this. It's going. All the example is here. Okay, so I'm making this is Control B bold. I'm making. Okay, so import system. Then from AWS Glue transform import star means everything. Then AWS Glue dot utils import get result options. From PySpark dot context import spark context, then like this is going. No need to memorize this one actually. So extract data from the data catalog. I'm making this on board. First import system, then extract data from data catalog, then transform data, convert to Parquet. You have to convert to Parquet, then load the transform data into Redshift. So after that, Redshift is going everything. Step 5, schedule triggers option analysis. If you want the ETL job to run automatically daily or when new data is uploaded to S3, very much important. This is when new data is uploaded to S3, create a trigger in the Glue console. So if you say in the interview that I set a persona schedule when the new data uploaded to the S3, then it creates the Glue console. Set the trigger based on time or events like an object being uploaded to the S3 bucket. Okay, so then step 6, query the data into Amazon Redshift. So query is coming here. After ETL job completes, the data will be loaded into Redshift cluster. You can now use SQL to query the data from Redshift to analyze for analyzing and reporting. So yeah, this is the SQL query. It will be done. Tools and technologies used: AWS Glue for ETL automation, S3 for data storage, Redshift as the data warehouse, IAM for managing roles and permissions, PySpark for data transformation in Glue ETL jobs. Okay, conclusion, this project demonstrates how AWS Glue can be used to create an automated pipeline for extracting data from S3, transforming it into optimized format, and loading it into Amazon Redshift for analyzing. So this is an automated pipeline. For you can also extend this project by adding more complex transformations, integrating with other data sources, or scheduling the ETL process for real time or batch data processing. You can add also the batch data processing also here. So this is the basic thing for the Glue ETL, and this is loading data, S3 data into Amazon Redshift. I hope this will be helpful for you guys. Please try yourself first. Then if you need any kinds of assistance, then please inform me. I'll then get the hands on. Okay guys, this is midnight here. I'm coming back with another